So we had an interesting case come to see us today. This is a gentleman that we did surgery on in June of 2021. Everything went well. He was very nearsighted and we did premium lens replacement on him. He ended up seeing just fine. And then he emailed me and said, all of a sudden, I can't see out of one of my eyes. What should I do?
So we did your surgery in June. We put in synergy lenses to both eyes. And then ultimately you were seeing fine. We got you 20/20 vision without glasses, near and far. And then you sent me, today's the 9th. You sent me an email like Monday or something like that?
Actually, yes, Monday.
And you said, what did you say in your email?
Well, actually, Saturday night, I was fine going to bed.
Yeah.
And then Sunday, I woke up and everything was really blurry. I couldn't see anything.
It just, and you didn't do anything different?
No.
And then you emailed me and said what?
Well, it's just that I couldn't see it at all.
And so
I needed to get seen.
Yeah. And so what did I tell you in the email?
Calm down and look at you look at me.
Okay. And you live where?
San Antonio.
Right. So I was thinking, oh, he's probably got some retina problem. And then I look in and I see your lens implant. Basically, it's called subluxed, and it's out of position. So we took you to surgery, and surgery took a while.
Yes, it did.
So we had to figure this one out. This is a single piece acrylic lens. This patient had a YAG capsulotomy. I've heard of lenses dislocating into the vitreous if they had a late haptic lens and a YAG capsulotomy. I've never seen a lens spontaneously sublux into the vitreous after a routine YAG capsulotomy, and that's what happened. This lens is just dangling by a little strand of vitreous so I can see it. And fortunately, we could bring him into our operating room the same day as he had his exam, and we thought to ourselves, well, hopefully that lens stays where we see it in our exam room, and hopefully it doesn't drop toward the retina, because if it drops toward the retina, we're going to have to send it to a retina surgeon, and we won't be able to manage that. So let me show you the surgical case and what we saw when we brought him to the operating room.
Here's the initial view of his right eye through the surgical microscope in the operating room. The synergy toric lens is basically floating in the vitreous below the visual axis. So how can we grab this IOL in a timely manner before it becomes like Jack, falling into the abyss and leaving Rose, like in the 1997 movie, The Titanic? In order to make access to the sublux lens easier, we move to a more advantageous position ergonomically. We move such that I'm seated above the patient's right eye. We then place multiple access points that we will need to grab the IOL and elevate it to a position so it won't fall into the vitreous abyss. I think to myself, I probably have one shot at grabbing this lens with micro forceps. If I'm unable to grab it on my first attempt, then I'll probably nudge the lens and it will fall into the vitreous, and the case will then need to be referred to our colleagues that perform vitreoretinal surgery. So this song is going through my head.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity, to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, just let it slip.
So we're able to, fortunately, successfully grab the edge of the synergy lens, and mobilize it, and bring it into the anterior chamber. Once we have the haptics anterior to the anterior capsule leaflet, we infuse viscoelastic anterior to the optic. A bimanual vitrectomy is then performed, and then we bisect the synergy lens with IOL cutters and remove each half of the lens individually. Here we trim the vitreous that is trapped to that piece of the lens. We repeat our bimanual vitrectomy. An anterior chamber maintainer is then introduced. We then insert the Panoptics toric lens into the anterior chamber. The trailing haptic is rotated such that the haptics are now anterior to the iris. Because we experience some persistent iris prolapse, we elect to place a tenonylon to close our primary incision. At this point, both haptics of the Panoptics toric lens are anterior to the iris. As you can see, we've placed some ink marks to help us align this toric lens properly. We place viscoelastic anterior to the Panoptics optic and place the leading haptic into the sulcus while the trailing haptic remains anterior to the iris. Then the trailing haptic is placed posterior to the anterior capsular leaflet. Then the superior haptic is then positioned posterior to the anterior capsule leaflet. This is the trickiest part of the case, where the lens could fall into the vitreous. The only variable supporting the lens and keeping it from falling back is the right edge of the Panoptics optic is still anterior to the anterior capsule leaflet. But then we use a cyclodialysis spatula to bring the left side of the Panoptics optic anterior to the anterior capsule to create reverse optic capture. We then gently nudge the lens into our best attempt at aligning it with the axis marks in the presence of reverse optic capture. We then use BSS on 27 gauge cannulas to aspirate and irrigate the viscoelastic from the anterior chamber. Myostat is then placed into the anterior chamber, and we make sure that there's no vitreous in the anterior chamber or extruding from any of the incisions that we placed into this patient's eye. At the conclusion of the case, the Panoptics toric implant is well aligned and appears to be perfectly centered with the microscope lights. We're now satisfied with the appearance, and the case concludes.
Pretty great case, huh? Pretty interesting. So we took out a synergy lens, which was a astigmatism-correcting synergy lens, replaced it with a astigmatism-correcting or a toric panoptics lens, and fortunately, he did quite well. So these are rare situations. I don't think I've ever seen this happen on one of my patients ever, but fortunately, because we know how to deal with complex complications from cataract and lens implant surgery, he was able to have a fantastic result. So I hope you found this video interesting. We certainly did. We learned a lot. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.
And you were really good through it. And then, how's your vision now?
It's perfect. It's better than my left eye, actually.
Yeah. So, so you're 20/20 far and near from your right eye day one after it was like a, I don't know how long it took, hour and a half, something like that.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.